Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the 12th episode of the MBU podcast, the official podcast for the Marvel Brick Film Universe, where members talk about all the kinds of the geeky stuff and all your favorite brick films in the MBU. I am one of your hosts, Alex, from Lone Clone Productions, and today I'm joined by my fellow freelance peacekeeping agents, FaZe, from FaZe Brick 01.
Why, hello.
Seb, Mr. Frozen Lake Man.
Hello.
And Dan, from Dan's Animations. Woo!
Hello.
All right, let's get going here.
Yeah.
So today is Dan's first time on the podcast. You're technically our special guest, even though we don't really have special guests on the podcast. But yeah. So how's everyone doing today? Y'all doing good? Doing fine.
Not bad.
Yeah. Not bad.
So
yeah.
So Dan here is doing a. He's doing a Masters of Evil series for the MBU once I get that written. But yeah. So,
Yeah, it's gonna...
So, we got a great podcast ahead of us today. All kinds of stuff coming out of San Diego Comic-Con 2016 this year. We got Ghostbusters as well. I'm sure we're gonna talk about Rogue One. All the DC and Marvel stuff. It's gonna be great. I swear. Yeah, but before that, we got some housekeeping stuff to do. First up, we have an exclusive preview for an upcoming MBU video, and that is Starjammers by Seb over here. Seb, would you like to talk about Starjammers and the exclusive preview for a moment?
So, Starjammers are a group of space pirates, and this is basically going to be their origin story. So, yeah.
Very nice. Very nice. Check out Starjammers.
All I'm suggesting is that we should be slightly more cautious.
Cautious? Are you seriously implying that these pirates could possibly breach the defenses of the Shi'ar? You are delusional.
Just think about it. We should be careful. There's been talks of many Shi'ar ships being pillaged. I just think that...
No! We should not be afraid of these Starjammers. If anything, they should be afraid of us. What was that?
That's where we
wasn't that great?
Wasn't that wonderful?
That was amazing.
I love it.
That's so amazing.
Yeah. So for Days of Projects Past... Yes. Shut up, FaZe. Days of Projects Past, we have underappreciated brick film, in my opinion. And that is Lego Nebula Eternal Winter Part 1. I can't remember the sequence of the words here. Lego Nebula Eternal Winter Part 1 of 2. And this is a
sure, it's Eternal Winter the Mad Titan.
Yeah, well, not anymore. Now it's Lego Nebula Eternal Winter. But this comes from A Few Good Films, Josh, and this was his first MBU video, if I'm correct. It's a tie-in to the whole Eternal Winter series. If I'm correct, Nebula, who is Thanos's daughter, I think.
Yep.
Thanos sends her out to get some stuff from the humans, like Casket of Ancient Winters. I can't remember. What was it again?
No, it's Loki's scepter.
Loki's scepter, that's right. And from there on, we get this incredible scene with like big face Thanos, but he's like a spooky ghost, kind of. He's like using telepathy or whatever, and it's great. There's like directional sound, so it's like Thanos is going around you if you're wearing headphones, and that's creepy. The creepier the better, am I right, guys? Ho. It's a great watch. I'm sure you'll see more of Nebula in Eternal Winter, and eventually when we do her when Josh does the second part, it'll be great. All right. So new spotlight, all the MBU videos and SWBU videos and all the LDCU videos that have come out in the last 2 weeks. First up, we have a trailer for Lego or for Death's Head Cross slash Death's Head Doctor Who. I don't know how you'd say that. For Death's Head Doctor Who trailer by Lisa Zanutt. Aaron's back at it again with brick filming, and he's got the Death's Head and Doctor Who trailer. Of course, that's what I've been saying. I'm rambling. but yeah, this was I believe it was teased in the after credits scene of Spider-Gwen, right?
It was, yeah. Aaron's talked about this a few times. I don't know if he's talked about it publicly, but I'm pretty sure the way Death's Head was brought over into Marvel from Transformers was through like a collision with Doctor Who. Mm-hmm. So I think this is his introduction story.
Right.
Huh.
Yeah. So nice. The thing is, we've been on the trailer. We re-uploaded it to the MPU channel because it's great. And a lot of people have been asking, wait, Doctor Who's not in Marvel? Doctor Who's not in Marvel? Doctor yeah. Who's not in Marvel? Can yeah, you do I... Men in Black in Marvel? Because Doctor Who's in Marvel. So the thing is, all right, for a short period in one of the decades, I don't remember which one, Marvel had the publishing rights to Doctor Who comic books, if I'm correct. I'm not like the chief knower person of this stuff. Word escapes me right now. But yeah,
you're not well versed.
Yeah, I'm not that well versed in this whole subject. Yeah. So Marvel owned the rights to Doctor Who for a while for comic book publishing at least, and then the Doctor Who publishing company came back or whatever, and then they're doing their own thing now. But yeah, for a period it was owned by Marvel, so there you go. I believe since Death's Head used to be a Death's Head used to be a Transformers character, he was like, you know, Transformer sized, so he's not a minifigure. But he had a run in with Doctor Who, and Doctor Who shrunk him, cause that's how that works. And now he's in the Marvel universe. Plus,
about
I mean,
4 years in the future.
Exactly. Plus, people seem to forget that the TARDIS can transcend space and time. So, yeah. Doesn't matter. So, yeah, people have been asking, oh, can you do Star Wars then, since it's owned by Marvel now for the comics? Oh, can you do Men in Black? No. The answer to those are no.
We can do, like, Big Hero 6.
Yeah, Big Hero 6. I mean, technically,
as you said in one of the comments, Men in Black is basically like S.H.I.E.L.D.
Yeah, that's a good point. So it'd be hard to have it.
Yeah, it's like Men in Black is just.
You know, it'd actually be cool. It could be cool if, does anyone know what the name of the organization is in Men in Black? There's like a name for it. I can't remember. Maybe it doesn't have a name because it's super secret.
I haven't seen a Men in Black film in years.
But, I mean, you have like the whole multiverse in Marvel, right? And so, you know, multiverse.
There are infinite
possibilities. So, you know, out there, there could be a possibility where the Men in Black replaces S.H.I.E.L.D. As like the chief, you know, peacekeepers or whatever. So yeah, there's that. Boom. Next up, we got Spectacular Lego Spider-Man Episode 6 by the Lego Bricks, Mario.
Paradox Pictures.
Oh, that's right. I keep forgetting. Paradox Pictures. Yeah, he changed his name. Was that within the past 2 weeks? I can't remember.
Yeah.
Yeah, he changed his name, by the way, so... If people are wondering where the Lego Bricks is, he's Paradox Pictures. Yeah.
I think if you even type up the Lego Bricks, I'm sure you'll find Paradox Pictures as well.
Like,
if you type up the Lego Bricks without putting like Lego in capitals, I'm pretty sure you come up with a documentary on the Lego movie.
Fair enough. Yeah. So Spectacular Lego Spider-Man Episode 6. We got Donald Mankin up to his dastardly deeds, kidnapping the family of Rhino and Sandman, and they look to a certain wall crawler for help, and it goes from there. Yeah, this was a great episode. I'm just amazed at how good Mario keeps getting throughout each episode with all his like animation and editing and all that great stuff. It's truly a sight to be seen.
I think in one of the scenes the voice acting was particularly good. It was in Aziz's pizza place.
Oh, shut up, FaZe.
that was really good.
Oh yeah, that was good.
It was horrendous.
I knew that guy was gonna say go.
So the funny thing about that is because I voice Mr. Aziz and like the pizza delivery guy. So what I was doing was like in between Mr. Aziz lines, I was like reading out the script. And I was like, oh, no one's going to deliver this pizza himself. So that wasn't supposed to be a line. But Mario's like, oh, I need to cast someone for this role. That's like one line. So I'm just going to rip the audio from when you weren't even trying. And it was a total accident. So, but he asked me first, so that's nice. Next up, from one Spider-Man to another, in a separate Ultimate universe, we have Ultimate Spider-Man Oscorp Infiltration by ETR Films. And finally, we have Miles Morales in the MBU confirmed now.
I'm just happy we got another MBU video from Ethan.
Heyo. Yeah, so we got Miles Morales. It's just kind of like a... This video is kind of like an introduction to him, a showcase.
So it's got some of the best fight sound design I've seen in an MU video.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really good.
It's incredible. Miles Morales, for Spider-Verse, I'm sure we'll see more of him. Yeah. So that's it for MBU videos. The last thing we have is an SWBU, which is a sister universe, the Star Wars book film universe. Last week we did an LDCU video, and now we got an SWBU video. And this is a big one. Boba Fett, The Hunt for Skywalker by JoeBoar1777. Jeremy spent such a long time. He put so much work into this video, and it's really evident by that. Based on issues 4 through 6 of the new Marvel Star Wars comic, it's all about Boba Fett hunting down Luke Skywalker because he's hired by Vader, and yeah, it goes from there. This is of course between episodes 4 and 5, so Luke doesn't
issues.
Yeah, Luke doesn't really have any training at all in terms of being a Jedi, but he somehow makes it out of there alive with a. A little help.
While being blind.
Yeah. I mean, he has a little help from someone.
Han Solo defeated Boba Fett when he was blind, though, so.
Oh, Han Solo shot first.
That's a very good point. But yeah, this is an incredible battle. Video. Jeremy adapted it as well into the script form. So, there's that. Big 11-minute video. It's beautiful. Be sure to check it out. Darth Vader sounds incredible because it's me, wink. Anyway, there's that. So that's enough of me talking for a little bit, hopefully. Now we're on to project updates, where everyone on the show here talks about what they're working on in terms of brick films, both personal and MBU. So who wants to go first?
Okay, I'll go.
There you go.
I'm still working on Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. I really can't work on anything else in the meantime because I've used basically all my gray and white bricks building the sets. So I have to finish shooting that before I can film literally anything else. I'm starting to feel a little bit burned out, but it's nothing I think I should worry about at this point. Right as of now, I'm actually rendering out a channel trailer just because I need something to upload in the meantime. Moon Knight Winter Soldier, I've edited the main fight sequence, which you could have found on A Few Good Films live stream yesterday. Was it yesterday?
Yeah, it was.
It was the other day.
Yesterday morning.
Yeah, yesterday. So, if you tuned into that, you would have gotten a laggy preview through screen share. Yeah, that's all I really have. Who's next?
Let's go with Dan.
Yeah. Okay. Well, for the MBU, I'm doing Masters of Evil project. Mm-hmm. And it's basically linked to a couple of things in the MBU. So I can't tell you that much about it because it might spoil it or something, but it's gonna be awesome. And for my own personal projects, I'm just working on a Civil War video. And that's it. That's mostly it.
What about Spider-Man?
Spider-Man episode 3.5 is done. It's a Spider-Pool one, and that should be out sometime this month, probably. So, yeah.
Cool.
Sib, yeah. Go on ahead.
So, what I'm working on right now is for the MBU, I'm working on Star Jammers, which you saw a sneak preview for that. And I also started a Batman series, which is finished. I've finished scripting the first episode and I've started animating it. And I've just about finished a recreation from the animated movie Batman The Dark Knight Returns. It's Batman versus the Mutant Leader, so that should be out soon.
Oh, is your Batman series a parody? Or?
No.
Oh, okay. It was a parody. Like, I was wondering.
I thought it was.
If I was wondering if you'd have your Killer Croc episode in canon.
No, that's a different series thing.
Okay.
Very nice. So I guess that leads to me then, right? Haha, Howling Commandos episode 2. I'm working on it. It's funny because I said I was going to have it out this week. I didn't. Obviously. There were some unforeseen complications in terms of scheduling. However, I'm almost done.
Is that code for I'm busy?
I'm actually not busy. No, I just had something that took a chunk. I was doing something that took a substantial chunk out of my day all last week.
Pokemon Go?
Yeah.
I can't argue with that.
No, Pokemon Go. I didn't. I only spent like 2 hours. Max, I spent like 2 hours a day for like 2 days doing that. Most of the time, I just played in passing. We talked about Pokemon Go last time. It's incredible. Now I'm a FaZe. You just turned to level 5, right?
I'm level 6 now.
Level 6. Oh, haha. That's
Team
fun.
Valor. Team Valor.
I'm level 14. You chump. Anyway. So. Yeah, no, it's a fun game. No, I'm it's something else I'm doing. It's like this personal project for this golf thing. But
what team are you on?
I'm on Team Valor. Can you not tell by my tweets? so yeah, Howling Commandos episode 2. I do my filming on the weekdays and then edit on the weekends usually. And on Friday, I just had everything done except for this tiny chunk of script. And I should be able to finish that up Monday, in which case, hopefully I'll have it out by next weekend. It'll definitely be out by the next podcast. I can 100% certain say that. Cause it's
I'm
just
holding
such,
you to that.
It's just such a minuscule thing left to film.
Just going to upload the next podcast in like a month?
Yeah, well, I mean... Shut
to
up,
give
FaZe.
Yourself time.
you've seen through my veil of lies. Yeah. So then after that, I'm announcing it here right now. I got an idea for a Lego Suicide Squad video. It's gonna be short, like a minute. This is gonna come out ideally after Howling Commandos episode 2. Probably like the day before the movie releases, but the earlier the better, of course, because you got to get those build-up views, am I right, guys? Ho! Yeah, and then after that, I'll probably be working on. It's tough to say. I've got a Thor short, but I might just go straight into Agent Carter because I have the Agent Carter lines. So I'm like, wow, I should probably start doing something on this. Yeah, that's pretty much all I got for now. So everyone talked about stuff. Let's go into media discussion.
Oh,
Ooh,
oh
yeah,
boy.
Oh, this is gonna be
wow.
a big one. Oh, we're 20 minutes in.
Ooh.
Great. So for those of you who didn't know, the past few days has been a San Diego Comic-Con, which of course is a plethora of
Woohoo.
news and
I
trailers.
think plethora is understatement, to be honest.
I don't know,
It's more
treasure
like
trove,
Armada. Really. Armada.
Doomsday. It's like you're drowning in all these announcements. Yeah, no, it's been incredible this year in terms of like DC and Marvel's media, like a TV and movie game. They've been absolutely crushing it. But let's get to a
Yeah.
little. We'll get to that in a moment. We have a few things that came out before Comic-Con that we probably should talk about. This is a new
I
thing.
just caught a Magikarp in my bedroom
Got a
on Pokemon
Magikarp?
Go.
The only way I got a Magikarp was from hatching an egg.
Oh, I've got two.
You live in the in I live in the middle of a friggin' continent, right? So
I just
there's
got one
no
in my
water
bedroom.
anywhere. Anyway, sorry.
Is that the
We usually don't talk about video games, even though,
Pokemon Go app?
yeah,
Yes.
we usually don't talk about video games, even though we talked about Pokemon Go last week. Haha. But first thing we have, Telltale. If you
Segment.
didn't know, Telltale is they're a video game developer, and they make kind of like these interactive stories almost. But you know you. Course control the characters and there are like various gameplay elements to them. And they're making a Batman Telltale game series, and they dropped
It
their
looks
first trailer.
fantastic.
They dropped their first
I think it
trailer.
looks really good.
I surprisingly have not seen that trailer yet.
You haven't
You
seen it?
haven't?
It's a gameplay trailer,
Ooh,
quote
I
unquote,
haven't seen the trailer.
even though it's not really a gameplay trailer.
I haven't seen the Batman one, no.
Yeah,
But
but
I'll be watching it probably tonight or something.
it looks incredible. I think it's coming out within the next 2 weeks, the first episode.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, it looks great. Troy Baker's voicing Batman, which is funny because he voiced Red Hood in Arkham Knight and
And he voiced
Joker
the
in
Joker in
Arkham
Arkham
Origins.
yours. Yeah.
He is a talented
Yeah.
man.
He's voiced Loki
He's
before.
done a lot of voices.
Wow.
His voice is everyone.
Booker Catch.
A lot of people.
He's like the
Yeah, he
Alex
has all the
of
voices in the
the
world.
professional voice acting world.
Yeah. But yeah, I'll definitely be picking this game up. It's great. Yeah. So, more trailers. We had Star Wars Celebration like a week or two ago, and a few things to come out of that. First thing is the Star Wars Rebels Season 3 trailer for. I wish we had Jeremy on, because he's a big Rebels fan like I
Yeah.
am.
Ooh,
But yeah, so it's there's been a time jump between seasons 2 and 3, of course, and the first 2 seasons of Rebels were first season was okay, second season was pretty good.
I preferred the first season.
The third
I've
season,
not seen any of them.
I think the third season is gonna get crazy up in here. People
That
love the Clone
seems
Wars, and people
awesome.
forget that the first 2 seasons of Clone Wars weren't really that good. Excuse me. Even though there were some very nostalgic moments, but I think season 3, this is where it's gonna get cray cray up in here. We got all kinds of stuff. It's gonna go be going into
Oh, I love the
holocrons,
clock.
blindness, all that good stuff. General Thrawn.
Futuristic Daredevil.
Yeah. but it's a long time ago phase. Or we
Ooh.
got Grand Admiral Thrawn is the big takeaway, which was a character from the extended universe, which was abolished a few years back, but now he's back in Rebels. He's got red eyes. He's that one character that everyone was thinking was the other Grand Admiral in the first Rogue One trailer. And from what I've heard, he's pretty ruthless and really hard to beat. yeah.
Well, if he's in Rebels, he could easily be in Rogue One, because Rebels is... I swear Rebels was canon.
Oh yeah, Rebels is canon.
So
probably not.
It's not out of the realm of possibility.
It's not out of the realm of possibility, but it's probably not going to happen. let's be honest here. Yeah. So now we're going into some Comic-Con updates. These aren't in like any particular order. First thing we have up is the Arrow Season 5 trailer and the Flash Season 3 trailer.
I haven't seen either of them. I don't really? Care.
I've seen the Flash one, but I haven't seen Flash Season 2, so...
Oh.
I know the trailer is about Flashpoint,
I'll watch the Flash trailer after this podcast.
I never saw it.
Because Flash... I'm only going to watch Season 3 of Flash to see if it picks up, and it actually returns to its former glory. I doubt that's really going to happen. I think it's going to stay at an okay show standard.
It's about Flashpoint.
Arrow, I don't bother with. Arrow gets so slandered that I've really just been put off. So I'm just like, yeah, I'm not going to bother.
You see, I have an issue with Flash. Nah, it feels like everyone's a lot of people just love this show and praise this show and make memes. Oh, Barry, you're messing up the timeline, lol, which is annoying. but from what I've seen of the Flash Season 3 trailer, it just feels like they're retreading old ground here, right? Because basically half the trailer is like, oh, I changed the timeline, so I don't know you that well, or I know you in a different way, or we have a different relationship. And it feels like they already kind of did that with, like, all the Earth 2 stuff in Season 2.
Yeah.
I tweeted all this out. I went on a little rant.
We're gonna go to Twitter.
It looks kind of boring, and I'm not really intrigued by Wally West. He's not a very intriguing character to me. At least this iteration of him. The way they built him up in the show.
The suit looks cool. The suit still looks cool.
Yeah, the suit looks great. And we got that new... Black Flash guy who people have been thinking maybe it's New 52.
No, we're getting another Black Flash.
Yeah.
Freaking speedster villain. Oh.
Yeah. We don't know how integral he's gonna be though, because he didn't like have any lines in the trailer. So maybe.
Now that it's Zoom in the Flash Season 2 trailer.
Oh, that's a good point. I can't remember the Season 2 trailer. But yeah, no.
It was mostly just clips from Season 1, and then at the end there was some blue lightning going around the city.
I need to catch up on the Flash.
I don't think we saw Flashpoint Batman in the trailer. I don't think we saw that.
Yeah, because they're not going to do Flashpoint Batman.
Yeah, it's probably because they're not going to have Batman.
I thought they were
going
to do that.
Yeah, but they can.
I thought they were actually going to do that.
No.
It'd be good.
That's what I was looking out for. I was like, oh, damn.
Yeah, no, they
that'd have been so cool.
DC's clearly making a split between their TV series and their movies. They had the whole Suicide Squad and Arrow Season 3, I think, and they just completely, killed them off. Totally. just because, they're making Suicide Squad, which we'll get into momentarily.
Is Arrow not bad at the moment?
It's hard. I mean, the last two seasons, Season 3 was bad. Season 4 was not good.
I've never actually watched any of Arrow. Just
watch
one episode,
the first two seasons. Watch the first two seasons. Laurel dies.
First two seasons are
great. First two seasons, Laurel dies, and then we'll see what happens with Season 5. So Season 5, I'm actually way more interested in Arrow Season 5 than I am Flash Season 3. To be honest.
I hate finding out that series has been renewed, but I also like it, because if I'm enjoying the series, I want it to continue. But if the series is renewed, and a moment during the previous season where it seems like that character is going to die, I know now that they're wrapped in impenetrable plot armor, because they've been renewed for another season. It just kind of takes all anticipation and suspense out of it, to be honest. Like, it's like, Like Superman's death in BVS, we know that's not permanent because we've got a Justice League film that's been announced already. And they're not going to... I know the trailers come out, we'll get into that later, but they're not going to do Justice League without Superman. At least not in the second part, at the very least.
Right. And, like, they're already confirmed... They're already confirming, like, Superman's going to have longer hair in Justice League. Well, he's back, you know? So, there's that. Plus, I don't think anyone was denying the fact that he's going to stay dead. Like, realistically, yeah. They kill him off in the second movie they have.
They killed him off in the comics, and they revealed, a writer revealed in an interview that it was a publicity stunt.
Oh, yeah, of course. It's always a publicity stunt.
Yeah.
Sell more comics.
Are they actually going to do that thing with, like, he comes back with the black hair and all that, the big long hair and stuff?
I think he's going to come back in his recovery suit.
They've said that he's has longer hair.
I guess that's kind of cool. Yep.
An interesting thing that just came out yesterday, actually, is they're making an X-Men show on FX, which is, of course, you know, owned by Fox, of course. And this is based around the villain, I think, Legion. And I'm actually really intrigued by it. Did anyone else see the trailer? Maybe? Probably not.
No.
I thought that was confusing, and I like it, to be honest.
Well...
I thought it struck my mind. The trailer
it's interesting.
Just so confusing.
Well, I mean, you kind of have to remove yourself from it, because, A, we don't know the characters. Nobody really knows the characters, except for people that know X-Men well. And, B, you kind of have to... I'm not even sure this is, like, a part of the whole X-Men universe. Because,
no,
I mean... They make references in the trailer to Professor X, and, like, he's the most powerful mutant we've ever seen, but I don't think it's in the film universe. But if it is, that'd be actually kind of cool on Fox's part.
Yeah.
I'm actually really intrigued by this show, because it's, like... This guy is schizophrenic, and from what I've heard, he's like he has all these different personalities, and his powers change depending on like what personality has surfaced at that point. So it's just I don't know. It looks funny.
Yeah.
I think.
That sounds interesting. I'll probably watch the trailer.
It's from the creator of Fargo, so he's show running this. So that's a good sign.
I've been binge watching Fargo season 2.
Yeah. so yeah, Legion, keep an eye out. It's 2017. A lot of things coming out in 2017. Then we had the Netflix bombshell big thing a few days ago, and that was a whole bunch of trailers and teasers came out. The first thing was Daredevil season 3 is confirmed. It's happening. It's going to be happening. I don't know when the
release. We knew it was going to happen.
Yeah, I don't know when the release date on that is. They had a little Comic-Con sizzle reel, which showed a few new clips from Luke Cage. Then we had the first look at, Iron Man, or not Iron Man, Iron Fist.
I knew Jeremy was happy about that.
It's a little, yeah, it's just a little teaser of kind of like, you know, looks like in this iteration, Iron Fist is, he's in a plane crash of some sort, and that's how he gets to Kunlun and all that jazz.
Are they not gonna put the dragon?
They might. I don't know.
Is that be interesting?
Jeremy started doing
nothing. In his intro, he gets the powers of Shao Lao during his training. That's not during like his parental loss. That's mandatory to be a superhero.
Yeah.
I know nothing about Iron Fist. I'm excited.
I wonder how much of the series.
His origin's mostly covered in Jeremy's series, Seb, to be honest.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't have a very good memory either.
If you just watch episode 2 of Lego Iron Fist, you basically get the gist of his origin.
And then, I'm actually going to be interested to see how much of the season they're going to devote to Iron Fist's origin, because it's a bit more complicated. And some others' origins, because there's like this whole kind of like greed and business side of things. It's actually really interesting, and I'm really excited for Iron Fist. Then we get like a shot of him punching open a wall. Jeremy, when are you gonna finish remaking that teaser? You started like the night it came out. I want to see it now. There are like 10 shots. Yeah. So Iron Fist, that looks cool. And then we had a Luke Cage teaser, which was a trailer.
That looks awesome.
Luke Cage that was great, looks incredible. That's probably the thing that's probably the most exciting thing to come out of like this whole news reveal thing. That or Iron Fist, depending on what you like more. Yeah. It's gonna be interesting because
he gets his like Luke Cage watch.
Yeah.
That's kind of awesome.
So it's looking like Luke Cage is—he's going to Harlem. He's not going to be in. We're moving out of Hell's Kitchen for once in the Netflix universe, and we're going to Harlem, where Luke Cage is he's going to be a hero. But yeah, just some of the action in that trailer looks absolutely incredible, and so creative.
It goes really well with the music.
Oh yeah, totally. The music's great. It's just kind of got like that Harlem vibe. He just like rips a pipe out of the wall and bashes a guy in the head with it. Not like from the wall, like he reaches into the wall, then pulls it out.
And he rips a car door off.
Oh yeah, the car door off. In the sizzle reel, for the Comic-Con sizzle reel, we saw a guy try and punch Luke Cage in the fist and his hand just like turns to gelatin. It's great. Final thing that came out is Defenders. They made a teaser for Defenders, which is coming sooner than we think, actually. Jessica Jones season 2.
It's like how they someone can cutting up a newspaper. Together.
Yeah. Who is Danny Rand? So Jessica Jones and Defenders are going to be...
Alex.
Yeah, what?
When you said who is Danny Rand, we could have put a John Cena joke in there.
Yeah, we're not doing that. So, Defenders. It's going to be interesting. They're filming it back-to-back with Jessica Jones Season 2, actually. So, what else is confirmed for 2017 for the Netflix shows? We got...
Wait, hold on. Yeah. Is Jessica Jones Season 2 confirmed?
Yes.
Oh yeah, that was confirmed a while ago.
Yeah.
Oh, I someone told me in a comment that it wasn't confirmed.
They're lying.
It's coming out next year. Is there a third Netflix show that's coming out in 2017?
There's the Punisher one, and they said there was the Secret one. I don't know if the Punisher one's 2017, but Punisher miniseries.
Yeah, Punisher's not. There's no way Punisher's coming out in 2017. That's a 2018 minimum show.
It's been announced though.
What else are they doing?
We need a Moon Knight one. I wish that Secret show was a Moon Knight one.
Oh, Iron Fist is probably coming out in 2017, right?
Alex, before we move on to the movie stuff, the Ghost Rider and Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
You should look in the news discussion.
Shut up. No, edit that out.
Why would you ruin that for everybody, FaZe?
Alex, that out.
FaZe just ruined the rest of the episode. Everyone type in the comments. FaZe is...
You're doing a Keemstar.
FaZe is a stupid jerk. FaZe is a stupid Brit.
I was going to type that anyway, to be honest.
Everyone type in chat, FaZe is a stupid Brit.
He's a stupid ninja.
No, please no. Alright. yeah. So, I think in 2017 we're going to be bumped up from 2 Netflix shows a year to 3 or 4. So, that's going to be fun. Movies. Starting it out with Ghostbusters 2016. Hey!
Has everyone here seen it?
I haven't seen it yet.
Alright, we'll try and keep. Well, no, I've seen it. We'll try and keep it spoiler free. So no spoiler alert this week. Sorry, Josh. I should just scrub through all the podcasts to find a soundbite of Josh going aw. That'd be incredible if I wanted to spend 10 hours doing that. Anyway, so Ghostbusters. This is just gonna be like a little discussion between FaZe and I guess. What did you think, FaZe? Did you love it? You hate it?
I quite enjoyed it, to be honest. I haven't seen what other people think, although I saw that when the first trailer came out, people were being vicious about it. Like,
oh yeah, people are still vicious about it.
Yeah, I really enjoyed it. Maybe I'm that one guy who's like too young to be truly critical of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But I enjoyed it, and I thought it was funny, like, had its moments. Yeah, I don't know much else.
For me, it's not a good movie, I don't think. People seem to be married to the idea that this is Ghostbusters, right? This is not Ghostbusters. This is Bridesmaids with using Ghostbusters as a license.
We got a savage over here.
Dozens of someone's people have made gonna this comment. Analogy.
Someone's gonna call you sexist in the comments.
No one's gonna call me sex. Oh, think about our audience here. Do you think we have any social justice warriors? You can't. It's because it's clearly not Ghostbusters. I mean, like, in the classic sense of Ghostbusters. The thing is, with new comedies nowadays, right? Like, most comedy movies, like, that are just comedy, like Bridesmaids, is that you have a general outline for the way you want a scene to go, like, in the script, and then you let the actors improv a lot, right? And that's where you get a lot of the funny moments out of that, you know, seem kind of, like, spontaneous. Because a lot of that's improv, and that is very evident in this Ghostbusters. And the thing is, like, you look back at the original Ghostbusters and Ghostbusters 2, that's like written smart comedy. You know, I don't want not smart comedy. That's just like written comedy. And the thing is with this Ghostbusters is that, you know, you got that improv, so it's different.
I enjoy stand up comedy, so I don't see an issue with that, to be honest.
Right.
It's
just, you know, it's different. It's not, people can't go into this expecting it to be Ghostbusters from 1989.
Yeah, I feel like a lot
just
of...
just with women, right?
A lot of people.
It's not
a lot of people
that.
Have gone in expecting the original.
Right.
And I see this a lot with movie, like, remakes and stuff, like with RoboCop. I didn't like the RoboCop remake, but people went into it expecting the original. Really don't like when people do this.
Yeah.
With remakes, it's okay to expect, like, for them not to change drastic parts of the script. But if you're expecting everything to be exactly the same as the original, with just pretty visuals,
mm-hmm.
it's not. You're not gonna be satisfied. That's just not the way it works.
Right. It's just you have to go into these kind of things with tempered expectations. You can't expect it to be the original thing. But it's just, it has to be different. So I went in with an open mind, and I had a good time. I think the $10 was worth it. It's clearly not a good movie. That didn't stop me from enjoying it. I had fun with the cameo. What did you think about the cameos, Faze? Because for me, like, half the cameos were good, and the other half felt really forced. Like Dan Aykroyd's cameo. Was that Dan Aykroyd in the taxi cab? Where we talked for too long?
I'm not sure, to be honest.
It might have been. I don't know. His forehead seemed kind of not tall enough to be Dan Aykroyd. Seriously, look at Dan Aykroyd's. Dan Aykroyd. Wait, how do you spell Aykroyd? He's got a big forehead, right? Oh, maybe that was that actually was Dan Aykroyd. Never mind. Yeah, that felt forced. Because that went on way too long. I thought the first half of Bill Murray's cameo was good. You know, like when he's on TV. But then when he came to see the Ghostbusters, that felt forced. And then the last one with the... what's the black guy's name again? I can't remember. That one felt really good to me as well. And the one with the women... or the females in the original Ghostbusters, those were pretty good as well. Yeah. So, I don't know. I had a lot of fun. You just have to go into it with an open mind. I thought it was funny at times. A lot of the jokes fell flat on their face, and there weren't really any jokes that made me, you know, have a belly laugh.
You mean the super? Do you mean basically the Supergirl and Flash crossover?
Yeah, I still haven't seen that.
I saw it a couple weeks ago. I was on the, I don't know if I was on the podcast where they talked about it or not, but maybe. From what I heard about it, I was just like, I don't know. Maybe that's just, I don't know, maybe that's just their opinion. When I watched it, I'm just like, eh.
Honestly, that's how I feel about most of Supergirl.
I don't really like Supergirl.
Yeah, I stopped watching like 10 episodes in because I'm like, ugh, I don't want to. I might start it now that the CW's got it for season 2. I don't know, though. And they got, like, Superman in the first few episodes, so that's probably what they're trying to do. Hook people like me in. They're like, oh, I guess I'll watch this.
Trying to lure you in.
Yeah. It's just, it's just their pop, I mean, their pop culture references in Supergirl, just, they're just not, they're cringy, you know? Like, oh, pop culture reference, haha. Sometimes they're funny, like they had that one CW joke. And that, in Supergirl, but, aside from that, which is actually really funny, because now Supergirl's on the CW, but yeah, it's, I don't know. Back to Ghostbusters, in terms of the characters, I really liked, oh god, I gotta look up their names, Kate McKinnon, she was the crazy one, right?
I think so.
Yes.
She was probably my favorite.
She was probably the saving grace of the movie, right?
Yeah.
She was probably the best thing to come out of that movie. However, she was overused. what else is the Ghostbusters? We had Kristen Wiig. She was good. Leslie Jones. She was way overused, I think, and kind of, you know, made into a stereotype, in my opinion. Kristen Wiig and Melissa McCarthy felt like the same character. There wasn't really any differentiation between the two. And Melissa McCarthy feels like the most out of place here, oddly enough. Because usually in Melissa McCarthy movies, you have Melissa McCarthy being the oddball, crazy person. And then everyone else is like the straight man. Like they're all about business and, you know, that you watch their reactions to her antics. But in this movie, everyone's like that, right?
Yeah, they're all a bit kooky in their own way.
Yeah, so it's not, that's, Melissa McCarthy kind of feels out of place, which is weird. Yeah, overall, not a good movie, but I had fun. The part with the dual pistol scene, I don't know, something with the music just triggered me, and I just had, like, the biggest stupid grin on my face. I did get triggered, but in a good way. Not in the social justice warrior way.
If anyone else wants to get triggered, watch my most recent video on my second channel.
I got triggered.
God, I think you popped one of my earbuds from the bass. Yeah. So that was Ghostbusters.
I succeeded then.
That was Ghostbusters 2016. We'll see if they make a sequel. Their first their first week's box office was pretty good, but then it dropped 60% for week 2, so
I haven't been looking at the stats.
Yeah, it's not that great. Then we had a Rogue One BTS reel for Star Wars Celebration. That looks good. I'm so excited for this movie. They had a new trailer that they showed at Comic-Con, but they are not releasing for some reason. Well, not for some reason, so that people are hyped about it. But it looks like a lot of this, a lot more of the stuff we've seen from the first trailer. But we had, you know, the big Darth Vader reveal, and everyone freaked out in the audience from that. So that was cool. Really excited for Rogue One.
I have to agree.
I don't really have anything else to say about that. More Suicide Squad stuff. They're really driving it home with the marketing for Suicide Squad.
Yeah, I have to.
Full trailers.
I feel very oversaturated.
I've been avoiding all of the they're doing new Suicide Squad trailers.
They haven't really spoiled the plot like BVS did, but they're giving a bit too much away.
That last, like, final trailer, even though it was after the final trailer, it was the Comic-Con trailer, that gave away too much, I think. That was the line in the sand where I'm like, all right, I should probably reevaluate myself here in terms of, because if you want to see that last Comic-Con trailer, that actually spoils plot points, I think. Not as bad as BVS.
I haven't seen the Comic-Con trailer.
Don't do that.
I've seen a couple of the character trailers, like the Joker one and stuff.
Yeah, the character trailers are fine. I think those are cool. a lot of the Comic-Con trailer takes footage from past trailers and a lot of footage from the character trailers and a few new things that spoil the plot. So it's not really worth watching, I think. I feel like anything past the final trailer, which they had, which was like the third or fourth trailer, which was a few weeks ago, anything past that...
It was the third main trailer, but
yeah,
they've had loads of TV spots, theatricals,
anything past that is for the general audience that doesn't know who the Suicide Squad is, and DC's really trying to get them to go. Because this is... Suicide Squad is not well known, right?
I think it's in the middle ground between A-list and, like, Z-list.
It's Suicide Squad's a B-list now. If DC can do it right, they might be A-list.
It will be explained in the film. Like, they've marketed it with cool characters like Harley Quinn, Deadshot and stuff. So people are like, even if they don't know who the Suicide Squad are, they'll still watch it for them, Batman, Joker, whatever.
Right.
And then I think they'll get their little dose of comic knowledge.
Right, and of course, you know, you got Will Smith playing Will Smith, so people are going to watch it for that. You have Margot Robbie, so people are going to watch it for that. So I think
she's done a really good job with her Harley Quinn, to be honest.
They're just really trying to drive it home, trying to get the general audience into the theaters, so I'm just not going to look at anything more. I think they showed another, like, a full clip from Suicide Squad the other day.
Yeah, I'd like to say I'm not going to look at more trailers, but I know I'm lying.
It's only like 2 weeks out as well.
Yeah,
I don't want to watch more trailers, but I feel I will. Yeah.
I've only seen like one or two trailers, so I'm happy about that.
Yeah.
Yeah, same.
I
don't want to look at any more trailers in case I get spoiled.
Yeah, just anyone who's like kind of in comic book, like the whole comic book kind of culture, should just kind of stop. And I wish I did yesterday, and I hadn't seen that last trailer. And then DC got more stuff yesterday. Wonder Woman trailer. We got a full Wonder Woman trailer.
Ooh. Yeah.
I actually haven't seen the Wonder Woman trailer.
You haven't seen
the Wonder Woman trailer? Oh my god, freaking nuts, man.
Wonder Woman is awesome.
At first I was like...
I've seen every other DC trailer, but Wonder Woman, I've not seen that one yet.
So good, man. All right.
Is it good?
Yeah, it is good. It is great.
Dude, it's fantastic.
I'll watch it later.
The only thing at the end though, like when they showed the logo, they had that me that like half people that watch BVS hated. I kinda like it, and that's why I put in my BVS.
Oh, I just realized you were talking about the Junkie XL thing.
The what?
I just realized you were talking about that soundtrack.
The one with like the really like whiny high pitch like the electric guitar.
If you didn't like that song, why did you use it in your video?
I liked it. I said that I liked it. I just said that, I'm just saying.
Why did you call it whiny?
Because it is whiny. That doesn't mean I don't like it. It's like it's a whiny guitar. I don't know. I don't know music. Wonder Woman looks great. I was kind of like, okay, Wonder Woman, that's cool. But now I'm like, I'm on for the ride. It looks great. This Comic-Con proved that DC is still in the game. A lot of people were thinking that after BVS it's over. Suicide Squad might be okay, but then that's it. Even though that's stupid because, you know, Wonder Woman's being released and Justice League is being made. Right now, filming. Of course, you know,
DC's... I feel like they make their films pretty fast.
Yeah, DC. Yeah,
DC's schedule's really... been set back a bit. Filming for BVS finished at the end of 2014. They were just kind of—I don't really know what held them back, to be honest.
Did they do? They did reshoots for BVS. That was like the—you can tell that was the whole warehouse scene for Batman because they said they were adding more Batman to BVS.
Okay.
You can tell that was the warehouse scene.
Maybe they should have shot more BVS, like.
So they can have like 3 hours. I don't know.
I feel like 15 minutes would have been sizable enough to keep us all satiated. Anyway, we're not talking about BBS.
Yeah. Wonder Woman looks great. Justice League. They also had a Justice League trailer, which I found odd, but then I realized it's coming out next year.
I think Aquaman looks great in it.
Aquaman looks great.
The most badass person in the trailer had literally one word to say.
Yep.
Talk.
It's he was like my favorite Christian part.
Bale. Yeah.
It's like Christian Bale's doing the vocals.
Aquaman is it's gonna put the Aquaman haters in their place. For sure.
Yeah. He looks all strange. The memes of Aquaman will stop after that comes out.
Oh yeah.
Well, they probably won't stop, to be honest.
Aquaman.
No, probably not. But he'll it's be more the internet.
Didn't even Batman say in the trailer? He's like, so what? You can talk to fish or something. Who said that? I can't remember who said that.
So where you can talk to fish?
I see too many people bashing it. Oh, too much humor.
I was expecting. Yeah, no, they're clearly trying to lighten it.
Oh,
up
I don't
bit.
Like Flash. Ooh, Cyborg.
Why does Flash have blue lightning?
I'm glad it's not as dark. Well, I'm glad it seems like it's not as dark as BVS was.
Yeah.
Dull.
Fun fact: when Batman was in. When he broke into Flash's place, Flash was watching Rick and Morty.
Yeah, one of his monitors.
Yeah, I
saw that.
So that was fun. Good guy, Flash.
Rick and Morty.
I just wish they'd get rid of that stupid, like, turn down the contrast so that, you know, there's no color in the film. It just looks too dark, for my opinion. I mean, maybe that's what people like. Because even like Dark Knight, even Dark Knight was like dark, but it didn't look, it wasn't black and white, you know? It had color, so, but it was still dark. Like, the way I imagine Dark Knight is like that one cover where it's like Batman, but like a big orange background, if anyone knows that one.
Yeah.
Anyway. Yeah. So Justice League looks great. DC's back in the game, I think.
Wait, hold up. Before we move on, thoughts on Flash and Cyborg and their like look?
Oh,
yeah, that's
I like them.
That's what I was gonna say.
Flash.
I think they should work more on like Cyborg's them. Cyborg CGI.
I gotta take a look at Cyborg CGI again, cause, but a lot of people have been kind of bashing it a little.
I feel like we're gonna have a repeat of the Civil War trailer, where. It's a CGI character that's been rendered it's been horribly compressed by YouTube system, right. So people are ripping it to shreds.
But even still, people saw Civil War and like bashed Spidey being totally CGI.
It looks like Cyborg has boobs, to be honest.
I think they're called muscles.
I think those are called two.
No,
I think those are called two YouTube diamond play buttons. Yeah, I got to find this picture somewhere. Anyway, I think Huck said that, tweeted that out the other day. Cyborg looks like a YouTube diamond play button. so I found that funny. Flash, the kind of I'm not used. I don't. We're not. I'm not really used to the armored look, but it looks good. It looks, I like it. I like that.
He moves a bit like a crackhead. There's that clip. There's that clip where they're doing like a montage of all members, like cutting from clip to clip of each member. There's one clip of Flash, and he just kind of like skits to one side of the room, just like he needs a crack fix really badly. And he's having withdrawal symptoms. I'm just kind of like, what?
What is this?
Damn it, Barry.
Run, Barry, run. I think people that were doubting Ezra Miller, he's great as Flash, I think.
There are going to be more timeline meth memes because they're going to compare that suit to the Nightmare Batman Flash suit.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Whatever, man. I don't even know anymore. So yeah, Justice League looks great. I think it was an interesting move on there. What's the release date for Justice League? March? Like how far into the year is it?
Not sure.
Justice League release date. June 14th, 2019? No, that's part 2. Justice League 2017 IMDb. November 17th. Hey, that's my birthday. Alright, happy birthday to me. Let's go watch Justice League. Interesting. Actually. Huh. So, there's still... That's an interesting choice on DC's part to show a trailer for something that's over a year out. But I don't know, I think it was...
That's not uncommon. They did that with BVS.
They did. I'm in the Marvel mentality, where DC's kind of more like respond to the market right away. You know, like something happens, we have to like, you know, the fans' reaction, they're getting antsy.
The same can be said for Marvel with Cap Hydra. So,
I mean, I'm talking about the movies. In terms of like trailer release, because Marvel has a very kind of like, a very specific methodology to how they, you know, they do three trailers and then one, two, three leading up to the movie, and that's it.
They do their trailers about 7 to 9 months in advance.
Yeah. Where DC's like, let's have something at Comic-Con that's like over a year out, more than a year out.
Well, I think they just wanted to put their cards on the table because Comic-Con's like a golden opportunity.
And that's what I'm saying. People have been really doubting DC as well after BVS, and you know, people aren't like some. A lot of people aren't liking the look of. I won't say a lot of people, but there's certainly a group of people that don't like what Suicide Squad's leading up to. And so I think DC.
I am kind of interested to see in terms of like plot points as how Suicide Squad's gonna affect the rest of the DC cinematic universe, they're calling it.
I don't know.
Because I can't really see that playing into Justice League, but I'm waiting for them to surprise me.
If you saw the final trailer for Suicide Squad, you can kind of see like how it does that. Yeah, so I'm sure it will, but it could be a different thing entirely.
I bet 2 seconds later, after this is done, FaZe goes and watches it.
Don't watch it. You're gonna regret it.
Watch it, Dan. You need to be watching the Wonder Woman trailer.
Yeah, I'll watch that,
mate.
I'll definitely watch that because I've heard good things about it. I've just never watched it.
Chris Pine. All right. That whole part with the secretary in Wonder Woman was great. He's like, "I'm a secretary. What does the secretary do?" He's like, "Oh, well, I basically do whatever he says. Where I come from, that's called a slave. I like her." He's like, "Let's just keep going. I really like her." That was funny.
Moving on.
Doctor Strange trailer number 2.
In this one, In this one, unlike the first one, Benedict looks at the camera in his Doctor Strange costume.
Yay! Finally,
we see him. Oh my god, this movie looks great.
Looks crazy.
Mind
stuff.
I feel sorry for anyone who really liked the trailer and feels like recreating it.
No one's gonna do that. You're gonna need a team of effects people and CGI.
You're gonna
need
to do actual CGI, like.
Yeah, totally. No one's gonna do that. Maybe some people might make like TV spots, maybe. But yeah, Doctor Strange just looks incredible, man. I don't know.
Looks very interesting.
Honestly, this looks like the most promising Marvel movie.
I forget it's a Marvel movie.
This also looks kind of like the most serious Marvel movie to me as well.
What was that Wi-Fi joke?
He's like, "What is this, my mantra?" He's like, "No, it's a Wi-Fi password. We're not animals, you know."
The new Marvel logo looks really cool.
Oh yeah, shut up, FaZe. We're gonna talk about that.
It's not in the news discussion.
He's ruining everything.
New logos for Thor and Ragnarok, Captain Marvel, Black Panthers, Guardians of the Galaxy 2, as well as a new intro for Marvel.
Okay, shut up.
Yeah, FaZe. Thank you for reading. back to Doctor Strange. We get to see some
Lego set based off the movie?
Yeah. Totally. Because there, you have the characters. Oh my god. That was loud. Because you have the guy in like the green robes there as well, and you have Doctor Strange.
What's the red thing in the set? Is that like a monster or something?
Yeah, it looks like some kind of like mythical being. Isaac actually.
Ostjack.
No, Jack doesn't have it.
I mean Ostjack, what it is.
It's probably whatever. I don't know. We actually got like thing. A villain reveal, I guess. It looks like some guy that's like being possessed by something.
A tentacle door.
Yeah, or in the Lego set. The Sanctum Sanctum.
Is that Lego set only available at Legoland or something?
No,
it's just there earlier than everywhere else. It comes out August 1st, I think.
Oh, okay. Cool.
So yes. A week. Wait, 30
Isaac's
days.
Got it. It's out in the UK. Isaac's got it.
Yeah, Isaac's
no
got
way.
It.
No way.
Yeah. I don't know if it's
going to all stores. No, he went to Legoland in Denmark, I think.
I've been there. I've been to Legoland Denmark. It's awesome.
Yeah.
I have never been to a Legoland.
Back to
Doctor Strange looks so Inception. Actually, if you look at that shot where like New York's getting like crumbled on itself, like that aerial view. You can see Avengers Tower in there. You can see Avengers Tower, which is, hey, same universe.
they need to remind you in case you kind of forget halfway through this movie that's like a Lost Airbender tie-in from the way it's shot.
I was thinking when I saw it, I was like, oh, wouldn't it be cool if it's like before the car crash, or he's in the car and Doctor Strange is like, listening to the radio, he's Tony Stark comes back from Afghanistan today, and then
that would be sick.
And then he does like all his training like over the past 8 years, and now he reveals himself as Doctor Strange.
And then kind of folds New York in half.
Yeah, that just like CGI on that looks nuts. Just
exactly.
Like, he constructs like that alleyway. It's just. Insane. I don't know how to explain
it. It's got to be one of the most highest budget visual effects films, of the decade. To be honest,
but Robert Downey Jr. is not in there, so there's a big chunk of money there for Marvel to give it. So there you go. One more thing to mention from Marvel coming out of Comic-Con, they showed Homecoming footage.
Did they?
Yeah, they did, but only to people in Comic-Con. I don't know if people have been able to leak it yet.
Someone's probably been recording on their crappy iPhone. It's got it upside down.
Vulture.
Yeah, people have been giving descriptions of what's happening. It's like at the high school and Vulture comes in.
Who's playing Vulture?
Oh, that's so...
Michael Keaton.
Ooh.
I think it's the guy that played...
Michael Keaton.
Yeah, he said Michael Keaton.
Michael Keaton, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, he did Penguin, right? In one of the old Batman films?
No, that's Danny DeVito.
Batman.
Yeah, he was Batman.
Oh, if they'd got Danny DeVito, he'd be an incredible
Batman
vulture.
In 1989.
Yeah.
Batman.
Danny DeVito would be an incredible vulture. Just look at his face.
But he's so, he's round. He's like... He's like a bowling ball.
CGI.
Just like get CGI his just like his plaster face. His face, like what they did with Steve Rogers in First Avenger, Chris Evans.
Oh yeah.
They CGI his face skinny. On the scrawny kid. Which, at times is kind of iffy, you can tell. Anyway. Last thing for movies, the Lego Batman trailer number 2. People are like, wow, doesn't this movie come out in a year? But then they realize that it comes out in February. So it's not really that far away. I don't know. This movie.
The Joker doesn't look very good. I think the trailer looks good, but the Joker I don't really also
the Robin. Really mixed feelings.
The Robin looks like Carrie Kelly.
The Lego movie was such a cash grab, but this one, I'm not really sure if it's a cash grab for sets or an actual film that they're interested in making. I feel like it's in the middle ground.
Totally, of course they have, their Batmobile that they're going to be using, which is that one thing from the larger set. And what else do they have? They had the Joker's Lowrider. People have been hating on that set because they also really.
Cool.
By the way, people, they also released set picks
cool.
for two sets they're going to be doing for the Lego Batman movie. I think that looks incredible. That's probably the best Joker vehicle we've ever gotten.
The actual Joker figure. That looks freaking nightmare.
I would buy it for the vehicle itself because it looks.
Yeah, I'm gonna go on eBay and get that and Harley Quinn. Harley Quinn's got roller skates. How much is
it? And Batgirl.
How much is it again?
Yeah, Batgirl. Like 30... Well, we don't know yet.
It's probably going to be like $60 for the larger one. Yeah. Does it help, FaZe, that Zach Galifianakis is voicing as the Joker?
I don't know who that is.
Okay, well, you're a lost cause.
I was never found to begin with.
Yeah, whatever. Robin looks like Carrie Kelly for some weird reason, even though they explicitly mention that it is Dick Grayson.
I'm gonna get it and use it for Carrie
Josh
Kelly.
Josh believes
though.
It's an incredibly exaggerated Burt Ward from the Adam West TV show.
No.
Adam West.
Holy hallucinations, it. Batman.
I like it though. Life doesn't give you seatbelts. And they do the.
Where's the seatbelts?
Life doesn't give you seatbelts. And then he slams the brakes. He's like, oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. I'll tell Alfred to install some seatbelts when we get back. yeah. Lego Batman movie looks incredible. The writers clearly know what they're doing with this one, and they're clearly fans of the whole Batman franchise. The part where they had the mariachi Batman.
Yeah.
There are going to be so many references to either the Lego movie. Or just Batman.
That's culturally insensitive. it's gonna be great. News.
Thoughts on the little belt piece they've introduced?
Oh yeah, I think it looks great. It looks great.
I hope it's not too chunky.
It's not.
Yeah,
it'll be fine.
Yeah.
News.
I hope you can still move his legs.
Okay. Yeah, you can. It's not. It doesn't really obstruct anything. No. So.
All right, let's go to news. Right. Before Alex explodes.
Shut up. news. We got lots of news. So Rogue One, it's taking place on this, the parts where they're, like, on the planet. With, the clips with the blind guy. That, name of that planet has been revealed. Oh, my lord.
Someone dying?
What was that?
That was someone, someone dragging their mic across the table. Or something.
Blowing their nose on their computer.
And then, so it's taking place on this planet Jada, which is, it's described apparently as like this kind of mecha of the Star Wars world. And if you don't know, Mecca is like the it's like the spiritual homeland in Islam. It's like required that you have to go there once in your lifetime.
Annually if you have enough money. That is, if you have enough money to spend,
you just have to
make a pilgrimage to Mecca.
Yeah.
So they
talked to, someone, I don't know who it is, they were talking about it, but they said, for me, A New Hope is kind of like the story of Jesus or something. There must be a whole religion beyond that. For 1,000 generations, the Jedi were the leaders of the spiritual belief system, he said, quoting the film's lore. So there's got to be the equivalent of Mecca and Jerusalem in the Star Wars world. And that world is Jada. I don't know. I think that's called Jada.
Just call it Jedha. The foundation of the Jedi religion. I wonder why.
I just realized that. Thank you, FaZe, for pointing that out. He said that the full backstory of Jedha and how it became such a place won't be told in the film. He assured fans that it's something the story group at Lucasfilm certainly know and has discussed. Summarizing edwardsfieldcomicbook.com, that if you believe in Jedi and you believe in the Force, it feels like Jedha is the place you should visit in your lifetime. It's a spiritual homeworld of the Jedi. And I think that's actually really intriguing, right? That the Force really is a religion, right? And just because the Jedi are gone, there are people that like probably follow this, believers of this religion, and they just don't have access to the Force, right?
I have to wonder if we'll see Han Solo in this film.
No,
we will.
We will not see
casted.
Han Solo. We will. Yeah, he's Han. Well, Han Solo is casted for the Han Solo movie. He's not Han. He's not casted.
I thought it was the guy from 50 Shades of Grey. casted, but I was like,
oh my god. What?
I think in the trailer you see people with like Jedi-like robes, or they said that somewhere. By the way, I was getting like all those quotes from comicbook.com for reference. Anyway, so that's cool. What's next? Ghost Rider is going to be in Season 4 of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Ha!
Yeah,
people have a reason to watch Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. again.
Guys, we've done this on the podcast already.
No, you just mentioned
it. I love
it,
Ghost Rider, mate. But I don't... I don't like Robbie Reyes, how the Chosen...
Reyes.
Yeah, Danny, you can talk about this. Yeah, I think this is a... I think they were saying something like Ghost Rider is going to be... the kind of like a big integral part of season four of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Which is actually
Are they not doing a separate series?
I think it's a
pretty
cool way
to Blaze?
Introduce
no,
him.
They're not. They're most definitely not. That's going to be the Ghost Rider.
That's a
Ghost
very
Rider.
Cool way to introduce to the MCU.
I would love if they did a joint
agency that deals in the paranormal. Because S.H.I.E.L.D. is basically like the Men in Black, as we've covered, and they deal with paranormal stuff, alien stuff. So it's cool to introduce Ghost Rider to them, because it could be like they're tracking him down, assuming it's a new metahuman, and then uncovering the truth about him. And he could worm his way into Infinity War. He might be one of the quote-unquote 67 characters we see.
There's no way they announced that number before, you know, they decided to put Ghost Rider into season four.
Yeah, but I think he'll worm his way in there somewhere. Yeah.
Anyway, what were you saying, Dan?
Yeah.
You were saying something
I just said I prefer the, like let's say if they did like a Johnny Blaze series or something, I was more hoping that they would bring the bike out instead of the car or something like that. But
did they show
I'm not really
they could be trying to distance
Robbie
themselves
Wade
from that old Ghost Rider film.
Right. Yeah, they're trying I think like all those films like Spirit of Vengeance and stuff that left a bad taste in a lot of people's mouths. So people are like, "Oh, great, Ghost Rider." And it's like, "No, this is a different one."
Yeah, they've taken that approach before, like with Punisher in the 2004 film. He had like his sleeves rolled up, he had the emblem and everything. He didn't get that emblem until like halfway through season 2, Daredevil. I think
he
was,
didn't
like,
get
in
it
the
until the
half.
End of Daredevil.
Yeah. My memory is a bit foggy, so they do try and distance themselves.
A bit
like
foggy.
Oh no! Oh, Daredevil jokes.
Like the Daredevil suit, the new suit, it's really cool. Oh, no, I'm sorry, I'm rambling. They've differentiated that from the Batfleck suit. Why did I call it Batfleck? The Daredevil Ben Affleck suit. in considerable measures.
Mm-hmm.
So I think they're going to do this for all the disgraced
less latex,
Marvel
more
characters.
Kevlar.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If you're a disgraced Marvel character, we will distance ourselves from
you. Did they show pictures of the car yet?
I think they did, actually. They had, real thing.
Yeah.
Car.
Big black one. Big black car.
My big black dream, or my big green
We'll just have to see what this Ghost Rider brings to the
Ghost
table.
Ghost Rider car unveiled by cast. Here we go, 2 days ago. What does it look like?
The one for the, see the skull?
Sorry, I'm watching a video
right now. See the skull in the teaser trailer? Is that the skull that they're going to use for Robbie Reyes?
Ooh, possibly. That's a good question. Wait, so have they actually shown the car yet? They have not shown the car yet. Okay, so that's a lie. I don't know, that might be the skull. Agents of the S.H.I.E.L.D. actually has a surprisingly good FX budget.
Yeah, they introduce
because
a lot of...
Doesn't he have, like, a metal skull?
I guess. I don't know.
Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. introduces a lot of the lesser-known sides to the Marvel Universe, like Inhumans.
Yeah. It's been a really good entry point for Inhumans as well. I need to watch
Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
It's actually going to be really interesting, because...
I swear last season they introduced, like, aliens and stuff.
They did. Yeah, the Kree.
Oh, they were the Kree? I didn't see much of it.
Yeah, no, because the Inhumans...
That kind of ties into Captain Marvel.
Yeah, the Inhumans are descendants of like Kree
experiments. Yeah, they're
experimentation.
So,
they had a few victims. Kree people. They brought back Sif, I think, for season 3 or 2. I can't remember which one. But that was cool. They need to use more Sif. She's cool. What were we? Ghost Rider. So, I don't know. It'll be interesting to see how they integrate the whole kind of Inhumans thing, because at the end of season 3, they had like a 6-month time jump, and Daisy is an Inhuman and she's off doing her own thing now. It still feels weird not calling her Sky.
I agree.
Yeah, she's off doing her own Inhuman thing, being like a vigilante or whatever. S.H.I.E.L.D. has a new director, and we don't know who that is. And it'll be interesting to see how all those kind of like the... Because the Inhumans have been like the main pivotal force, driving force for Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. for the past 3 seasons.
Were they in season 1?
Well, yeah.
Season 1 was all Hydra.
Yeah, season 1 was a lot of Hydra, but elements of Inhumans were introduced then. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
I feel like partway through season 2, when the Winter Soldier movie came out, they were just like crap. It's like, so the series took such a drastic turn, and it wasn't really explained for anyone who hadn't seen the film.
Right. Well, yeah, that's how Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. works.
They're really the underdogs to the rest of the MCU. If any film does anything paradigm shifting, they have to adjust their scripts regardless of their plans.
Oh yeah, season 1 was Winter Soldier. Season 2 was Agents of, season 2 was, what was it, Age of Ultron, and then season 3 was Civil War. So.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
So now I don't know. It was actually kind of funny because at the end of season 3, they have this Inhuman that can blow up anything that he touches.
Reminds me of Plastique from Flash.
Yeah, the way he handles some thugs is like he grabs a chain and like whips it to them and blows it up in their face, kind of like Ghost Rider-y. So maybe, I don't know, maybe this has been stirring around in Marvel Studios for a while.
Interesting.
Kind of smaller thing that came out of Comic-Con from Marvel, we got new logos for Thor Ragnarok, Captain Marvel, Black Panther, Guardians of the Galaxy 2, and of course, Marvel has their new intro, which is a lot more kind of grand in scale. Shows some clips from the MCU movies. It's really cool and much longer now.
I prefer the old one, but this one's still pretty good. Yeah. I think I just need to get used to it.
And now it's not like Marvel, big Marvel, and then Studios at the bottom. It's Marvel Studios. Hey. So that's cool.
What are they going to do for Marvel properties that aren't done by Marvel Studios, like X-Men?
Well, they're probably not going to put in the Studios part. Or they probably are still going to have Marvel Studios.
Marvel Studios is the MCU. Stuff like X-Men and Fantastic Four and Deadpool
still,
is just
they
Marvel.
Still have a hand in it, though,
they can
right?
keep the,
like, they
the
still,
old.
It's still their property, technically. Not in the filmscape, but like it's their characters. I don't know. We'll see. People have been making fun of the Thor Ragnarok logo. I love it, personally, because it's just like, it reminds me so much of Kung Fury. It's like an 80s SNES, even though SNES was the 90s, kind of thing. I'm so excited for Thor Ragnarok. They confirmed that Hulk is going to have, like, the World War Hulk
armor
on. It's just going to be, because that's one of the things that AOU left. Wait, no, not AOU.
Yeah, AOU.
Age of Ultron. That's one of the things they left off. Hulk's gone. Okay.
Yeah.
So we'll see how it kind of transitions from
I
that.
I kind of forgot Thor Ragnarok was a thing.
To Thor, like, picking up Hulk and them going on a buddy cop trip across space. So
we're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
Yep. Final thing for news this week. Brie Larson, she was in Room, not The Room. She was the mom in Room, and she was someone in Scott Pilgrim. She's officially casted as Captain Marvel. Rumors have been going around for a few weeks now that she's she's been in talks, and now it's official. She is Captain Marvel. Screw you, Darren. I know you want to include Grace Moretz, but she's way too young. Anyway, there's that. Yeah. Whew, that was a big media discussion. What's her time looking like here for an hour and 25 minutes? This is going to be a long one. Excuse me. All right.
Have fun editing.
Dan, do you want to read the first question? Or do you have the document open?
Yeah. Hold on. Okay.
Yeah, says hold on. There are only two people other than myself there on the document.
Right.
Yeah, I'm on the document.
There you go.
This is from Smith Rose Studios. Which of the trailers from Comic-Con are you most excited about?
Iron Fist.
I'm most excited Wonder Woman.
Oh, yeah, sorry, I forgot about Justice League. Yeah, Justice League. Definitely.
Wonder Woman, I think.
Justice League.
Justice League brought a lot of new things to the table, but honestly, I didn't... For all the other trailers, I was like, oh, that's pretty cool, and I, like, smiled a bit. But Doctor Strange was the only one where, like, my jaw dropped. So for me, it's Doctor Strange. All right, Seb, you want to take the next one?
JGL Animations asks, which of the 7 Harry Potter movies is the best?
Aren't there 8?
Harry Potter, Prisoner of Azkaban, and Harry Potter, Goblet of Fire. They two are my favorites.
I like the first one.
I kind of like the first one as well.
Prisoner of Azkaban.
Nostalgia.
Yeah.
I haven't seen...
One will always be the best one, but yeah.
I've seen all of these movies, but not since 2011. I never went into the theaters to see any of them.
Watch them again, Alex.
No, I'm not gonna do that. Oh, Jesus, something in my throat. What was the third one? Wait, what was the one where he was like playing Quidditch like in the rain? Was that the third one or the second one?
Isn't all of them?
I am not a Potterhead in the slightest.
Harry.
That was Prisoner of Azkaban.
Prisoner of Azkaban. That one. That's my favorite. My favorite one is what's that new movie?
Same.
Mythical Creatures and Where to Find Them or whatever. Isn't that a Harry Potter thing?
Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. Is that what?
I might see that. Cool. I don't know.
I want to go and see that.
I forget.
I'm interested.
Their names. Like the names of the
Fantastic
films.
Yeah. Anyway, Faith.
That was cool.
All right. A Barbecued Brick Film Productions. How do you go about with planning films and series in the MBU and making sure they all connect? Well, we have a timeline, and there is a public version of this timeline.
There is actually.
Yeah, there is. That's available.
It hasn't been updated very long. All right. Yeah.
Oh. But there is a public timeline if anyone's interested, and it's just the writing process. If there is a script in the MBU, we check to see if it fits in continuity and if there are any opportunities to make it connect with something else, and we just kind of proceed from there. We try to use similar styles of like minifigures and stuff when collaborating, so that each character doesn't have a revolving costume.
The key word is try, of course.
Yeah, with Captain America's hair.
Of course not. Yeah, shut up. Of course not everyone has the same access to every single minifigure in every single set, so.
Yeah, if we have a character that looks different to... Like, take Jack's Iron Fist, for example. I actually kind of like that suit, but it receives a lot of criticism for being a Batman torso. If there is ever a difference in style from the regular costume, we always make sure to include a note about it in the script, just to keep it in continuity if we're forced to do style deviations. And that's all I can really say about this.
What we do is we usually have like a big story arc we want to do. And for videos pertaining to like a big story arc like Ultron Paradigm, we'll usually have like the story arc in mind, kind of like a general outline for what we want to happen. And then we can kind of just like fit in various videos and puzzle pieces from there. And yeah, Faye's kind of covered everything else.
It's like a web.
Yeah, it's like a web. You know, a lot of the times writers go into writing scripts with the intent of usually connecting to like something, one other video, a lot of the time.
Yeah. Making a reference to it.
Making something. A reference in some way or another. For me, I'm kind of like carving out like the whole World War II pre-60s era.
With a little help from William.
Yeah, with a little help from
my boy William. Prime example of this is not about the World War II thing, about like references and stuff. Spectacular Spider-Man Episode 5, Jessica Jones made a little mention about Yellow Jacket, which will play into some other story arcs. Involving Jessica Jones and stuff.
Doesn't that directly reference the Jax Ant-Man versus Ant-Man and Hawkeye versus Yellow Jacket video? Because
Darren's
Jessica,
video.
Yeah, Darren. Sorry, Darren's video. And then Jessica Jones was like in the building next door.
Jessica Jones is actually going to pick that up in the series. Along with a few other videos. I know Leo is working on a video right now that's going to contribute to that arc.
Yeah.
And I'm pretty sure Austin Security Solutions video, whenever he gets back onto that, I know it was kind of burned out. Whenever he gets back onto that, we'll contribute to that arc, and we kind of go through the same process with all of our story arcs. Just people contributing in different ways. We've yet to conclude a story arc, but when we do, I think people can go in the playlist, watch it through, and truly feel like satisfied to see a story arc all fit together like this.
I mean, in like series, there are like specific like series. There are like series specific story arcs, like Mario's season 1 of Spider-Man. That was like a complete arc. There are like a few arcs.
It had a few ties with.
There was like that. There was like that Hydra arc in Daredevil. So yeah, but like in terms of like a grander kind of story arc, yeah. Insta Giblo asks 20,000 times, are you ever going to make Men in Black? No. All right. So, Dan, you want to take the last one as our special guest here?
Dan?
Men in Black is S.H.I.E.L.D. Remember that, kid.
Yeah. Dan, you want to take the last question?
Yeah.
There's one more question left.
Yeah.
Yeah, you want to read it?
Do you want to read the last question on the door?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's your turn to read it.
Captain Bricks asked, out of the three Marvel movies coming out next year, which one do you want?
Lego sets up the most.
Me?
Yeah. Oh, no, which one do you want Lego sets up the most? No, you just read the question, Dan, and then we all answer.
Oh, my God.
For reference, the three Marvel movies coming out next year are Homecoming, Guardians 2, and Thor Ragnarok.
I think Spider-Man, just because I love Spider-Man.
Doesn't Spider-Man already kind of have his own line of sets?
I don't think they're Ultimate Spider-Man. The movie, though.
So that's for Ultimate Spider-Man.
They
have that stupid.
And you get Spider-Man.
They have that.
That's true.
That's for Ultimate Spider-Man. They have that stupid bright costume that I hate.
Is the Vulture's costume.
Spider-Man seems like the obvious choice, right? But
Guardian sets could be awesome, Guardians, but I don't know if Lego are gonna do a repeat line of Guardians.
Yeah. Oh, they you know they are. Did you know how many sets of original Guardians they sold?
I only bought the Nova one.
I'd actually like Guardians as well, because I never got any of them. So I know you can buy all the minifigures on Bricklink for pretty cheap.
But
Guardians 2 would be cool. Thor, though, I want to see a Hulk big fig with the armor on. That would be cool.
Yeah.
You only need one set from Thor.
Your question's already been answered. Buy the Green Goblin big fig, rip one of his arms out, and just give it to the AOU.
Yeah,
the Hulk.
That would be sweet.
Well, no one wants to use the AOU Hulk. I want Selena. I want the bright green Hulk. Hey, there's someone having a midlife crisis. Yeah. So.
I tried that. I actually tried.
A midlife crisis?
I tried that.
What, 15? 15? It's like an eighth life crisis. Not eighth. Like, sixth. Sixth life crisis. Anyway. That's all the questions we got. This has been a long podcast.
Is that it?
Yeah, that's
it's not even been 2 hours. It's like an hour and a half.
Yeah. Thanks everyone once again for listening to the MBU podcast. We got Alex, Seb, Dan, and FaZe. Thank you guys once again for listening. And we'll see you in 2 weeks. Bye.
When Helen Commandos will be out by then. Bye.
Please don't re-upload this podcast like the last one.